We welcome you in to Loving Good Arena on the campus of McEachern High School. It is the McEachern Indians and the Wheeler Wildcats in the nightcap of the Georgia's Elite Eight tip-off classic. Joel Hillsman, Sylvester Williams, Barry Browner. Well,
here we go.
Here we are. Wheeler and McEachern, two teams in Cobb County, in Georgia, in the South, with national attention. And we're glad that you're with us here on the SUVTV.com.
So many matchups, so many things I want to look at, and so many things to try to figure out. What's the matchup to watch? What do you want to watch? Joe, I'm going to be honest with you, Joe. What I want to watch, you know I love the big men. I want to watch E.J. Montgomery battle down low with Jerry Jones and Akinbola. Did I say that?
Babatunde Akinbola.
Akinbola, I
said
it.
They call him Stretch. Okora, Akinbola, Jones, Cooper, and Suggs, the starting five for the McEachern Indians. Jair Eastman, Austin Johnson, Brandon Younger, E.J. Montgomery, and Isaac Martin, the starting five. And there's the alley over right on the question to Isaac Okora. 2-0. Crowd is raucous here.
Way to start. Oh, and an over and back. Over and back by Wheeler.
Head coach Larry Thompson, his first season, and Wheeler taking over for the great Duck Lipscomb. Mike Thompson, his 12th season at McEachern, the head coach, and he's got a team deeper than deep. Here comes Coop. Coop gonna stop. Jumper, all right, rolled off. No, Montgomery got the rebound here, and he's got the handles and puts it on the floor. Montgomery now gonna take it, goes over to Martin. Martin now holds it back, looks, and now gonna give it to Eastman. Eastman gets a screen over in the corner, a long three. Martin, good! He banged home a three. Isaac Martin, formerly of McEachern. Coop now to Bush. Wheeler with the 3-2 lead in the early moments. Akinbola holds it out high to Coop. Sharife Cooper bounces it over to Suggs. Suggs goes up off the window. No. Rebound comes down to E.J. Montgomery. Montgomery going to bring it up with the left-hand dribble. Montgomery going to hesitate. Spins it over. Here comes Martin. Martin foul line jumper. It rolled off. Jones got the glass. Gives it over to Suggs. Suggs into the forecourt. Hands it over now to Sharife Cooper. Cooper to Suggs. Suggs now here is Okora. Okora gives it now to Jones. Jones back to the basket. The Akinbola foul line jump. Good.
Hey, good start by both teams. They're looking push the ball a little bit. Obviously, they're trying to get it into their big.
Martin three, no good, and he's fouled. And Martin will go to the free throw line. I'm sorry, Barry. Go ahead.
Is that a three shot or a two shot?
We can't see down in that corner. I don't know if it was a three or not.
The crowd is on their feet over here. We're behind the student section, so we can't see what's going on in the corner. It's tough for us down there. Hey, you can't even – if you move, I still got 30. I got 50 students in the way. It doesn't even matter. I appreciate the thought, though.
Martin to try the free throw. Back on good. You know Isaac Martin has to be kind of feeling some kind of way. He played for McEachern. Transferred over to Wheeler last year. The Wheeler Wildcats. Adidas versus Nike. No good. Martin struggling now after missing two free throws.
That's funny that you say that about a high school team, but it is Adidas versus Nike. Wheeler last year, they were on the Adidas commercial.
Free throw good. So he goes 1 of 3, does Isaac Martin. 4-4 ball game. Coop into the forecourt, picked up by Eastman, pulls a three, no good. Rebound by Suggs. Suggs underneath. Suggs takes it up off the window. No. Tip. No. Suggs underneath the Jones. Jones got it knocked away. Jones recovered it. Jones up jump. Good.
Good shot. Hey, if you look at what McEachern did right there, they got a couple of opportunities at that bucket. And took advantage of a good putback by Jared Jones on the short jump.
Austin Johnson with his back to the basket. Now he goes inside, floating away, and no good. A foul call. Brandon Younger was fouled. I think that's Jared Jones' second foul.
Yeah, that's 2-0 Jared. That's big. They're going to have to pull Jared on off.
One of the interesting matchups you got to look at is the point guard matchup with Jahir Eastman and Sharife Cooper. Eastman's got to do a job of making sure Cooper can't get to his spots and make that shot that he likes to make. Also, he's also disrupting him as far as getting the ball and distributing to guys like Akinbola and Jones in the court.
You know, Sharife Cooper may be the best point guard in his class. Without a shadow of a doubt, he's the best point guard in the state of Georgia in his class. Without a shadow of a doubt. But he might not be the best point guard. He might be the second best player in his house.
Younger split the free throw. Here's Okora. Okora now to Akinbola. Akinbola with a jumper. Good.
Good shot, Akinbola.
Babatunde Akinbola. They call him stretch for defense, but he stretched it out with the jumper there.
One of the things we talked about earlier tonight was big guys stepping out and being able to shoot the ball. Akinbola just showed you he can do that.
There's a
6'9".
Yes, he can. Coop to Suggs. Suggs back. Okora, pump fake, put it on the floor. Now back to Coop. Corner three. Sharife badly missed. No tip by Jones. And a foul called on the floor. That'll be on E.J. Montgomery, I believe.
You know, one thing I like about Jared Jones, Jared Jones looks like over the summer he's gotten bigger. If you look at his legs, Jared Jones looks like he has two tree trunks down there for legs. If his upper body ever catches up to his lower body, Jared Jones is going to be hell on wheels.
He looked like he's definitely starting to fill out a little bit.
And look at the little battle between Austin Johnson and Jared Jones right here at the elbow. Coach Thompson walking up and down the sideline. There's the inbound to Akinbola to Coop. Coop now holds it, worked on by Eastman. Okora holds it in the left corner, worked on by Martin. Goes to Jones. Jones over to Cooper. Good ball movement. Now looking at a zone defense now. Jones going to show the range. Hill of the rim, no good. Rebound tip to come down to E.J. Montgomery. 4:45 to go, 8-5. McEachern with the lead. Montgomery going to drive. Eastman, a corner, three.
They hit that big shot. Good shot by Eastman on the dish by the big fella, E.J., bringing the ball down the floor.
Okora up, got it blocked by Austin Johnson. Johnson got the block and recovers it. Martin down in this corner to Eastman. Eastman, another three. Good. Jahir Eastman banging home three balls. 11-8, Wheeler's got the lead. Here is Cooper. Cooper now goes behind the back, worked on by Eastman. Now he's going to drive over to Suggs. Suggs back to Coop. Coop now holds and looks at that zone defense. The Wheeler crowd loud and raucous. And they give it to Jones. Jones holds, worked on by and Montgomery. Now Jones going to turn on him. And he got to take it away.
Take it away from him.
Here comes Martin. Martin up ahead. Eastman, pump fake. Step, a three.
Bang! Walk out the gym.
A quick nine.
And they need a timeout. They have called a timeout.
A quick nine points.
The entire Wheeler bench went over and chest bumped that young man Eastman. Hey, look, I'm going to be honest with you. Eastman was one of the biggest question marks for this Wheeler team. A lot of people were concerned what type of player Wheeler would be. I mean, what type of player Eastman would be. They needed guard play. And Eastman, he shows he can shoot, boy. He shows he can shoot. Woo.
And I told you when we started off, that's the first thing I said. One of the matchups that I wanted to watch was Sharife Cooper and Eastman.
Yes, sir.
He's done a good job so far.
And here's the thing. We know that Coop, from a point guard, Scott, has been very poised. The question mark was his jumper. It has improved over the course of the summer, but he's missed a couple here. Eastman now, conversely, on the other end, is showing the confidence and showing the range.
Exactly. Eastman's doing a good job as far as getting to his spot. And like I said, he's being found by his teammate. A quick 9 points for Eastman, that's big.
A quick nine. I like that. A quick nine.
14-8 out of the timeout. Sharife Cooper with the right-hand dribble picked up by Eastman. Now Coop going to drive with 3:38 over to Akinbola. Up off, no good. Rebound on the floor. Suggs can't get it. Eastman comes away with it, and a foul called on Brandon Younger. Coach Thompson has lost the jacket.
early in the game.
He didn't make it a quarter.
He didn't make it a quarter. The jacket is off with Coach Thompson. And I love Coach Thompson as a coach. First year over from Green Forest. I love the intensity. One thing I can tell you about Wheeler. Wheeler will be a tough team this year just because of Coach Thompson.
You can tell by how this game's going. This game is starting out to be a little physical. So definitely Coach Thompson brought a little bit of that with him from Green Forest.
Here's Jones. Jones now. The Suggs. Suggs a three. Brandon Suggs. A three ball.
Nobody's afraid of the three ball here.
14 to 11. Now going to take it and drive. Kick to the corner. In the corner, Eastman again. Bounces it in to Johnson. Johnson goes up and scores.
Strong finish.
Strong move.
And that's a good move because Akinbola had solid defense play. Here's Okora. Okora now to Jones. Jones at the top, worked on by Johnson, hands it over to Suggs. 16 to 11, Wheeler with the lead. Okora from deep, front iron, no. Montgomery snatches it off the glass and gets the board up to Younger. Younger into the forecourt. Younger now to Eastman. Eastman turns, looks, it's on the ground, it's a turnover. Up to Eastman, came and got the steal. Eastman, a three ball, no. Off Johnson, oh, and in. Austin Johnson up ahead quickly. Here's Bush. Jones all the way off the window. No. Montgomery got the rebound. Wheeler's got a 7-point lead. They're in transition.
You got to give that up.
He lost it. They go on the floor diving and a foul call by the center official. Let's see.
I know it feels good to be a big man to dribble like that, but you got to give it up.
Man, they're getting together.
A lot.
They're yapping. Brandon Suggs and E.J. Montgomery, and a technical foul has been called.
A little bit of cross-town rivalry, cross-Cobb County rivalry going on. It's on and popping.
The crowd is ready. I'm ready.
I told you it was a big fight field, and like I said, so far, holding true to form. I like the intensity, man. I noticed Wheeler got a technical foul, but the first thing Coach Thompson did, come out, greet his guys, hey, clapped it up and told him, hey, let's go. We ready to roll.
But you know, we talked about physicalness in our other game. I like this intensity.
Right.
I'm exactly. Okay with that.
I'm okay with it.
If you going to jab and talk a little bit, you're supposed to. Now play ball. Exactly. I'm all right with it.
But now it's how do you control your emotions. Now,
I understand.
Now we're excited. Now everybody's happy. Now what do we do now? How do we control that emotion? How do we corral all of that energy in? Because, see, if you go off and you're half-cocked and you're yelling and you're up in somebody's face, you're going to get two texts and you're out and game's over. Doesn't matter.
Right.
You got to understand how to control that. It's a mind game out here, too. You got to figure out who's playing this mind game, which
18 to 11, they have not indicated who the technical was on. We are upstairs across from the scorer's table. And we look like now in the perch. Let's see, no technical was called because they're not allowing anybody to shoot. Devin Gordon is into the contest, number 25 now for the McEachern Indians. He's the first sub for either team today. It will be side out of bounds. Isaac Martin will be inbounding it. Wheeler in the navy, blue and the gold. McEachern in the white. The home whites at Leavenworth Arena. 18 to 11. Wheeler with the lead, 209. And a foul on Sharife Cooper. Jair Eastman not really afraid of Cooper.
Now, like this, you got to look around and see who's talking to who. See who's trying to talk themselves out of a game.
Montgomery now to Eastman. Eastman going to fly it up on the alley. No. Suggs outlet it. Here comes Coop. Coop going to drive all the way. The Okora, the passes. Lady was out of bounds. You don't see that often from Sharife right. Cooper. A poor decision in open floor, Baron.
Right. He definitely should have gave it up a little bit early. He was just a step too late.
You know, something like that. He could have been selfish on that. He had his man kind of shielded off the defender. He could have laid that up for 2 foot by himself.
To the bench. There's a drive off the bench into the scoreboard. Isaiah Holt, the 6'2 senior. Holt quickly into the scoring column.
McEachern tried to come with a press. Wheeler broke the press and got an easy layup.
Here's Okora. Okora up and a foul call. The Wheeler crowd across the way and the Wheeler people. The McEachern, oh, heck, everybody in here hype. Okora going to the line. He started it off with the alley-oop dunk. but has not scored since.
And you can tell the difference on the sides of the arena. We're on the student side of the arena, it seems like. We have the Wheeler students and the McEachern students, and everybody's standing up, so we got to stand up. Our center camera can't really see. We got our cameraman holding the camera up by hand to try to get above the crowd. It is, my goodness, this place, this is a championship fight. I love it. I love it when you said it, Barry, championship fight. This is what this is.
Everybody is standing. I feel like now I'm at a college football game. Here is Okora's second free throw. In and out, no, rebound tip, and it comes down to Younger. 20 to 12. So now here's Younger. Younger between the rings, worked on by Okora. Gets a screen. Younger down the right of the lane. Nice dime drop, layup. Oh, Darius Gaddy with the finish.
6'8" sophomore.
Good finish by Gaddy, the big fella finished at the basket.
And they were patient on the pick and roll.
Yes.
Exactly.
And that's coming off the bench now. Here's Okora. Okora now to Allen Breed, who checks into the game now for the Indians. Breed now gives it to Coop. Here's Coop. Sharife Cooper going to drive, gives it off to Akinbola, dunked it home.
Akinbola, impressive game. I think that's 6 or is it 8 for Akinbola?
Akinbola now up to 6 points. Babatunde Akinbola. 45 seconds to go. It's still an 8-point game. Wheeler with the lead. Here's Eastman. Eastman going to drive. It was knocked away from behind and out of bounds.
Eastman got him listed at 5'10". He's a junior, showing it up big in his first quarter.
Inbound to Younger. Younger takes it, spins it to the corner. There's Martin, a three ball, good.
And what I love with Martin, did Martin shot the shot and looked directly at the student section. He said, I know all you guys, you know me. You know it was good when I put it up.
Coop driving, left hand layup, could not finish, tried to get fancy. Gaddy got the board. Here comes Younger into the forecourt. Younger's going to hesitate right of the lane. Lost the dribble, but now recovers it. Picked up by Akinbola. Gets it into Gaddy. Gaddy back to the basket. Spin. Move. Up. No. Rebound. Tip. Fight for it. Coop's got it. Up ahead. Here comes Okora. Dunked it home. The clock running. Eastman a long heave. No. Well, well. 25-16. Wheeler leading McEachern. Catch your breath. I will catch mine. It's Georgia Elite 8 Tip-Off Classic. PSUVTV.com.
I got a high ankle sprain going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of playing.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
Check this out. Did you know that you can have all kinds of delicious food from your favorite local restaurants delivered right to your door? I know, I just blew your mind. All you have to do is go to choicestoyou.com. Choose from a list of great local restaurants, pick what you want right from their menu, and Choices to You will deliver it to your home or office. It's that easy. Get real restaurant food from the places you love delivered right to your door. Choicestoyou.com. Eat out without going out.
Very quick thoughts on that first quarter.
Good first quarter for both teams, man. I thought the Wheeler really punched. They came out and they punched McEachern in the mouth. So I hear Eastman got it going with a couple of threes. And like I said, they've done a good job so far.
Gordon, a three.
Answering back.
Devin Gordon, a three ball, no good. Loving Good Arena. And everybody in front of us is standing. Everybody. Literally. And we are now standing too.
We have to stand up. Cameraman has to hold the camera up even higher.
Here's Martin. Martin goes over in the corner. Holt rolled the baseline, tipped out of bounds, no good, and it will stay with the Wheeler Wildcats. So it's Gaddy, Younger, Montgomery, Martin, and Holt, the five on the floor for Wheeler. Okora, Akinbola, Gordon, Cooper, and Breed, the five on the floor for McEachern. There's a three ball by
Martin, no good. Tipped out. Here comes Coop. He's with Okoro. 2-on-1. He slowed it up. Went up and, oh, he got fouled. Isaac Martin.
And this is the second time that's kind of happened to Cooper. It seems like he's being too cool. You get what I'm saying? It seems like he's being a little bit too cool. I want to see the aggressive Cooper go to the hole.
25-16. Laid back Sharife Cooper at the free throw line. Up and no good. Cooper struggled from the field at times last season with the jumper and at the foul line. I think that's going to be the biggest factor for him.
No doubt. He's got to hit a shot or two to get himself going right now.
Had a very, very productive summer, a number of 30-point games on the EYBL circuit. Glad that you're with us, DSUVTV.com. Hope gives it over to Montgomery. E.J. Montgomery to Martin. Martin lost it into the backcourt. Allen Breed wanted the backcourt. They didn't give it to him. So Breed is going to pick him up in the backcourt with 7 minutes to go. 25-17. Martin, get it out of here. Blocked by Akinbola. Okoro comes away with it. Okoro to Breed. Breed on the break. Got it knocked away and a foul.
Travel call.
Good job of contesting by Holt. I'm sorry.
Hey, I saw that coming. I knew he was going to travel before he did it, though.
Yeah, it's all about being under control. That player control is so important.
6:45 to go. Younger across the timeline. Coach Thompson, he shredded the jacket long ago. His first game as the head coach of Wheeler. He gives it over to EJ. EJ now spins it to the left, and here's Younger. Younger looking for the screen from Gaddy, picked up by Gordon. There he is. Gaddy caught it. Gaddy put it on the floor. Akinbola, Okoro right there with him, and a foul call. No. A traveling violation. And Gaddy turns and looks at the refs and says, hey, man, he was really bottoming me up. That's good defense, though, from Okoro.
No doubt about it. Definitely bodying him up and making the turnover.
But you know what I like about Gaddy? Gaddy's a sophomore, big body kid. His mentality is, if I get the ball, I'm going toward the basket. I like the aggressiveness out of the young sophomore.
Gordon has it. Gordon bobbled it. Now here's Akinbola to a cutting Okoro. Okoro off the window and scores.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
25-19. 2 minutes gone by second quarter. Wheeler with the lead. They're in possession. Here's Eastman.
See, a lot of this game is about how you move without the ball. Okoro did a good job of cutting without the ball.
Montgomery spinning up. No. Offensive foul. E.J. Montgomery. A turnover for Wheeler. 5:57 to go.
And Montgomery's forcing it right now. I don't think Montgomery scored yet. So on that possession, he realized he wanted to get the ball and he wanted to score. So he's forcing the possession instead of letting the ball move around in the offense and get those wide open threes like they've been getting earlier.
Also, anytime you got a game like this, this is also a game of runs.
Yes.
Definitely a game of runs where, you know, you got to be able to sustain somebody else's run and they got to be able to sustain yours.
Allen Breed. Get the dip-de-doo, lift the goal. It's 25-21.
And now if you look at that, notice that McEachern has sustained that punch, and then they're coming back and they're throwing their own punch.
You're right, and they started this second half, the second quarter, with a 5-0 run. No good. Johnson got the rebound, put it back up and in. Austin Johnson now with 6 points in the contest. Quickly back this way is Cooper. Cooper lost it. A turnover. Here comes Holt. Isaiah Holt running all the way. Shot up, bothered. Tip back Younger. No, out of bounds. Off of McEachern. It will be Wheeler basketball. Stat Row showcases youth sports highlights and gives a portion of its revenue back to teams. Visit StatRow.com today to learn how your team can partner with Stat Row. 5:10 to go in the inbound in the Eastman. Eastman goes across the timeline. Now tried to split the double team, a turnover. Here comes Coop easy and cool on the break with the layup. Good. And Coach Thompson does not like it. He calls a timeout. First field goal for Sharife Cooper. We'll keep it right here. 4:54 to go. CBA Sports is a sports construction firm specializing in performance, athletic surfacing, sports floor systems, and sport components for both indoor and outdoor sports flooring projects. Visit cbasports.com for more information. So Coach Thompson, a quick timeout after a 7-0 start here to this second quarter by the Indians.
Coach Larry Thompson is one of my favorite coaches in Georgia high school. And the reason for it is the respect that he demands from his team. You know, when he called that timeout, the Wheeler players kind of walked toward the bench. But Thompson, he walked back toward the free throw line and said, nah, you guys come out here and you come to me. I don't come to you guys. And it's just a complete different Wheeler mentality when it comes to their team, when you compare the team from this year to the team from last year. I just like the aggressiveness and the energy that Coach Thompson brings.
4:53, clock moving now, 27-23. Martin between the rings to Younger. Brandon Younger holds it. Now he spins it to the left to somebody I cannot see. Who is that? Hope. Hope gonna shoot. Jumper right over Alcora. Good.
Isaiah Hope.
We cannot see anything that goes on in the corner.
So now here's Cooper. Cooper gonna set it up. 6-point lead. That broke that little 7-0 run. There's a zone defense being shown by the Wheeler Wildcats. So Sharife pulls a three. No good. Front iron. They tip. Fight for it. Akinbola comes away with it. Put it up. No. They tip. They fight for it again. And Younger's going to come away with it. 4:10 to go. Second quarter. 29-23. Wheeler with the ball and in possession. And the lead. There's a drive by Younger. No. Good. No call. Gordon got the rebound. They wrestled away from him in a foul. I like the way Barry Akinbola makes sure he has everything from the floor to the roof. That's why he's not getting in foul trouble like he did last season. He got in early foul trouble.
Right, and he's able to change shots and make guys think twice about bringing it to the basket anytime he's down there.
And, you know, and that's that year of maturity that you look for out of your players. You want your players, because what happens when players – when they at certain players, when they're a young age and they start to become nationally ranked, they don't get any better. They live off of those laurels. But you have a young guy like Akinbola. He just worked hard, and you can see the improvement in his game.
Gordon missed both free throws. Okora got the offensive rebound. The clock is not running. It's stuck at 4:02. I'll take the free basketball. And now the refs have caught it.
Had a few clock malfunctions so far today.
They are letting the clock run until the refs say stop it. 3:50 they put on the clock. 29-23. Clock moving now. Breed gives it, spins it over to Gordon. Gordon, a long three, rattled out. No, dunk. Couldn't put it back in. Akinbola could not. Hope got it. Pass stolen by Cooper. Cooper lost it behind his back. Okora picks it up. Okora's going to attack. Okora driving left. Good.
Good finish. And this team, they're making buckets right now. And Will is not able to make a couple of buckets here and there.
Eastman layup. No good. Okora gets the rebound. Here come the Indians in transition. Okora all the way. Layup. Good.
Big time take by Isaac Okora.
He's turning it on now. He has 9. It's a 2-point ball game. 29-27. Younger going to drive. Shot bothered and blocked by Akinbola. Get it out of here. Coop running. Here comes Cooper. Cooper down the lane. Offensive foul. Sharife Cooper.
That was a tough one right there to take.
Willis got to settle down. Hey, they need a bucket on this possession right here.
And you're right. They need a bucket. This is a possession where you run your offense. You run whatever offense Coach Thompson puts in there, and you run it to completion, and you get a good look and a good shot and score a bucket. No rush shots on this possession.
29-27. Gordon now picking up Younger. Here's Holt around the screen. Holt going to drive. Shot up. Bothered by Akinbola. They tip. Fight for it. Breed can't get it. Martin got the offensive rebound for the Wheeler Wildcats. Spins it into the corner. There's a three from Holt. Good. A three ball from Isaac Holt.
Big time shot by Isaac Holt. That's what Wheeler needed.
Holt with 7 in the contest. We're under 2.5. 5-point ball game, 32-27. Spins it in the corner to Gordon. It's not there. In the middle, to Akinbola, who dunked it home.
Hey, you see the difference between Akinbola and what we saw earlier today? Earlier today, the post players put the ball on the ground with a power dribble, and then the little guards came and picked the ball up. What Akinbola did, he caught the ball, drop step, and pounded it home. That's a big-time player right there by Akinbola.
Well, I can tell you what's going on. Will is playing the 2-3. They're starting to flash the guys up top, and they're leaving Akinbola on the baseline. He's finished twice like that.
Here's Hope. Hope held it and gives it over to Eastman. Eastman going to drive with the left hand. Put it up. Get it out of here. Get that shot out of here. Babatunde Akinbola, his third send all of the day.
And, Joe, you said it. That's the difference that Akinbola makes. He's able to block shots and make guys change shots.
and contested that one. Here's Okora gets the rebound. Up ahead to Allen Breed. 1:50 to go in the first half. 32-29. Man, it feels good to be back in the basketball season. McEachern and Wheeler in Georgia. Glad that you're with us wherever you are. Breed holds it. Now spins it to the left. Putting it on the floor is Bush. Over to Breed. Breed, a three. Come on.
Tie ball game.
It's even with 90 seconds. Down in the corner. Looking in the holding. Martin kicks it back out. Here's Holt. Holt being worked on by Breed around the Gaddy screen. Holt pulls a three. Air ball. Gaddy chased down, flying into the camera.
Protect the camera at all times. We got Daniel down there. Protect the camera at all times, kid.
Nah, that's Carl coming right into your living room. Glad that you are with us. The SUVTV.com. 70 seconds. Here's Gordon. Gordon now holds it with 1 minute, even at 32. Akinbola on a cut to Okora up off the window. Good.
He's killing him on that cut. He is killing him on that cut. Okora is killing him. And that's what I keep saying, moving without the ball. He is a master of doing that. I love that guy. I love Isaac Okora.
McEachern has the lead. They trailed by 9 as the second quarter began, and now they lead by 2.
McEachern's getting on that slide, they're basically pacing themselves. Guys moving, cutting without the ball, and then they're getting the ball in the right spots and making plays.
Yes, Quentin sir. McElroy into the contest. The defensive pressure picked up 25 seconds. And the pass was knocked away. Gordon got the steal. Don't call a dunk at home, boy.
Big time finish by Isaac Okora, who's starting to have a great second quarter.
Eastman comes flying back this way, and it was up and no good. Coach Thompson wants to know where the foul occurred. And I'm kind of right there with him. And I should say Coach Mike Thompson, the head coach of McEachern, because Coach Thompson is also Coach Larry Thompson of Wheeler. Eastman at the free throw line, 12 and 2:10 seconds. Loving Good Arena, jam-packed. Eastman, free throw, 1-1, good. Eastman now in double figures with 10. He's lit fire into this place with 3 straight threes in the early moments. Back iron, no. Gordon gets the rebound. Now here's McElroy. McElroy with his first action to close out this quarter. Here's Gordon. Gordon going to go baseline, put it up. No, and he was fouled. Who will they get it on? Will it be on Gaddy? Let's see. It will be on Gaddy. And Devin Gordon with 4 and 8:10 seconds will be going to the free throw line.
You know, that's a good foul right there by Gaddy. Well, it's a good foul that he missed the shot. You know, anytime you go to the line, you want to make him pay for it.
Back iron, no good.
And he missed the first free throw, so it was a good foul.
Three-point game, 36-33, 4 and 8:10 seconds.
If he misses this one, it's a great foul.
Gordon, one more. Up and in, and good.
Wheeler will have to settle for a good foul.
4.8, long inbound pass to Holt. Holt catches, fires a three at the horn. Ooh. No, saved out of bounds. And that is the end of the first half. A thrilling and electric first half here at the Georgia's Elite Eight Tip-Off Classic. The McEachern Indians 37, the Wheeler Wildcats 33. The SUVTV.com.
I got a high ankle sprain, going for a rebound.
Injuries are part of play.
I got hit catching a pass and broke my collarbone.
So it's good to know that the sports medicine doctors, therapists, and athletic trainers at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta are experts at treating young athletes. If your child suffers any kind of sports-related injury,
I got hit and dislocated my shoulder.
Bring him to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.
I'm OG, y'all new to the game. OG, y'all new to the game.
We get ready for the second half. Glad that you're here with us. Georgia Elite 8 tip-off classic here on SUV TV. Joel Hillsman alongside Sylvester Williams and Barry Browner. E.J. Montgomery scores right out of the gate. And the foul to hoop and the harm E.J.'s first field goal of the contest, 37-33. 35 now.
You know, me and Barry were talking about that at halftime. It's like E.J. has been very, very quiet. He's been doing work on the boards, but offensively, E.J. hadn't been heard from. And now, if Wheeler wants to win this game, E.J. Montgomery has to be a big factor.
Jarrett Jones, Sharife Cooper, Babatunde Akinbola, Isaac Okoro, and Brandon Suggs, the 5-on-4 for the McEachern Indians. It is Jair Eastman, Brandon Younger, E.J. Montgomery, Austin Johnson, and Isaac Martin, the 5-on-4. For the Wheeler Wildcats as they play the zone defense with Suggs holding it with a left hand. Suggs sends it over to Okoro. Okoro to Cooper. Cooper now to Okoro. 13 points for Isaac Okoro to lead McEachern. 8 for Akinbola. Steal. Montgomery.
Montgomery, you got to get out. See, somebody has to be a guard and step up and get that ball from E.J. Montgomery.
Here's Montgomery going, looking around the screen. Now didn't use it. Drives, put it up with the left hand. No. Tip. And Johnson is going to have it. Austin Johnson turns on Jones and a foul call.
Nice move by the Tennessee State commit, Austin Johnson.
Yeah, somebody just has to get that ball from E.J. Montgomery. I don't feel comfortable with him dribbling out on the perimeter like that. You got a guard. You got a guard for a reason. Let him be a guard.
Go ahead, Bear.
Well, I definitely think that Coach Johnson went in at halftime and realized that E.J. hadn't touched the ball that much. He's looking to try to get him the ball a little bit. Notice there's been twice that they've tried to go to him early on.
And those were sets, you could tell, coming straight out the set to go to him. Johnson split the free throws. Suggs rebounds and outlets to Cooper. We're tied. A minute gone by third quarter. 37-37. Okoro now to Cooper. Cooper to Devin Gordon. Gordon, they're working on that zone defense, so Coop's going to pull a long three. Air ball. Badly missed. Cooper has struggled from the field in this contest. He only has 3 points. A shot to passing lane. Here's Montgomery. Lost it. Akinbola defensively with the steal. Here comes Cooper. Cooper running on the break. Going to attack on Johnson. Threw it up. Didn't get the call. Okoro got the rebound. Okoro looks, and he double dribbled. You know, I want to go back, Barry, to what you said about the guard play. It's obvious now. Let's see how Sharife adjusts. He's not hitting anything. We know him to be a poised basketball player. How does he adjust now and affect the game since he's struggling from the field?
Well, anytime you struggle like that, I feel like you got to do other things to get yourself going.
Yes.
Whether it's playing defense or whether it's getting guys involved and making assists. Sharif's got to find a way to get himself going. Then eventually his offense is going to kick back to him.
Exactly. Make yourself strong in other parts of your game. If you got one part off, it's plenty of parts to your game.
Stat Row showcases youth sport highlights and gives a portion of its revenue back to teams. Visit StatRow.com today to learn how your team can partner with Stat Row. Stat Row going to be busy with this one, I promise you.
Plenty of highlights for Stat Row to put out there.
37-37, glad that you're with us on your phone, your tablet, your laptop, your desktop, and heck, even on your TV, because I know you are. 37-37 and a timeout, full timeout call by Coach Mike Thompson and McEachern. He is upset about something and wants to put some things in order. We'll keep it right here. 7A semis last year is where the McEachern Indians fell out. But we talk about the growth and development. They didn't play a big, heavy national schedule last year. They were able to play Scotlandville out of Louisiana, a big victory. That's not the story this year. City of Palms.
Yes, sir.
Cancer Research. Flying to the hoop. They upped the schedule very, very quickly.
And I think the reason why Coach Thompson did that is because he feels like he's got enough horses to run the big race and get to the Dix National Tournament. And he's doing what Wheeler and the Norcross have done in the past. And so I think now he's got a group that he feels that can make that run. Winning this game tonight would be a big step in that direction early.
Yeah, got to do it early, and you got to do it. I like what they have in place, highly ranked a lot of places, number 13 in the prep circuit, number 5 in the max preps, in the preseason rankings.
This Wheeler team, though, is not too bad. And Coach Thompson, you can already see his fingerprints on this team.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You can tell by the aggressiveness that this team is playing, that Wheeler's playing. Wheeler just, they have a tough guy attitude. And I think a lot of time your coach reflects on your team so much. And, you know, Larry Thompson, tough guy.
And we talked about Rasul Chester having to fill big shoes at Miller Grove. Larry Thompson having to fill some very big shoes here of Dub Lipscomb retirement. There's Akinbola up off, no good. E.J. Montgomery, the rebound. Eastman is hurt. Jair Eastman has been injured, and he's limping and now goes down in front of the bench. Barry, you talked about the matchup, and, man, this is a good one here. Coach Thompson walks over to him, and now Coach Thompson walks over to him as well.
You know, you're talking about filling big shoes. Anytime you go to a program and they have a coach that wins championships, that's tough. But when you go to a program and the gym is named after the coach, that's real tough.
Yes,
right,
it is.
No doubt about it. I mean, Coach Lipscomb's done so much in Georgia high school basketball. And then just being the coach around the country, he's considered one of the best ever to do it. So in giving him that, Coach Thompson does have a big shoes to fill. But let's think about this, though. Coach Thompson have won championships also at Green Forest. So Coach Thompson understands what this heat is like.
CBA Sports is a sports construction firm specializing in performance athletic surfaces, sports floor systems, and sport components for both indoor and outdoor sports flooring projects. Visit CBASports.com for more information. And to piggyback on you, Barry, he went from 1A private, where they played a big national schedule, to 7A in the top of Georgia. So it's not new to him at all. That's goaltending. They didn't tip it in. It didn't get it out of here. Get that shot out of here. Akinbola blocked it away. It goes up again. No offensive foul.
EJ starting to get, one thing I'm noticing, EJ starting to get a couple of touches, but he's not able to finish around that rim.
I'm thinking that, like you said, affecting the shots with Akinbola.
And the great thing about Akinbola, I love how you guys say affect the shots, because he doesn't have to block every shot. Now, he blocks a lot. He has 4 blocks so far in the game. But how many shots has he altered tonight?
Cooper now over to Suggs. Suggs holds it, now gives it to Coop. Coop's going to put it down with a left-hand dribble. We're coming up on 5 minutes to go, third quarter. 37-37, we're tied. How fitting is it? Being very patient on the Indians. Okora going to try to go baseline. Montgomery shut it off. Isaac Hope, by the way, took the position, took the spot of Eastman, who's still getting looked at behind the Wheeler bench. Left ankle, left foot they're looking at of Eastman. Here's Gordon. Devin Gordon holds it, spins it to the left to Coop. Now to Gordon. Back to Suggs. They work it around the horn. Akinbola now. Okora, jumper, a 3. No good. Akinbola couldn't get the tip. Rebound to Younger. Here come the Wildcats in transition. 4.5 to go. Austin Johnson has it. Martin left open. The lefty pulls a 3. Splash.
This is his gym. You can't give him that.
Long 3 right back at you. Devin Gordon. Gordon now with 4 points. His first field goal. We're tied at 40. Mix and match. Jumper. Montgomery. No. Martin follow. Blew the tip. Gordon gets the rebound. Here comes Cooper. Cooper now with the left hand dribble. He'll peel it back out. They'll set it up and give it over to Okora.
He's forcing it.
Okora to Gordon. Gordon off the screen. 3. Good. Devin Gordon. And you saw what that, Barry. He came on the backside behind the zone.
Exactly. He did. And got a he actually was able to keep his head and take a good shot, even after being challenged by the long arm E.J. Montgomery on the wing.
Younger foul by Brandon Suggs. Suggs kind of quiet, but he can affect the game and get hot as well. He only has a 3. Being looked at by Georgia Tech, Rutgers, among others. Auburn, of course, has a lot of influence in this game, and Rutgers as well. A lot of talent on the basketball floor between these two teams. Here's Martin.
Somebody out here is going to get paid to play basketball in a couple of years.
Oh, yes. I was about to say a number, but I didn't want to shoot too low or too high. Here's Martin between the legs over to Holt. Holt now worked on by Coop. Spins it to the left, and now they'll give it over to Martin. Martin goes around the screen from Gaddy. Martin stepped back with a hand in his face. The 3 ball did not fall. Suggs gets the rebound and gives it over to Cooper with 3:10 to go. Pace has kind of slowed, 43-40. Okora out of the triple threat. Gives it to Suggs. Catch, fire, a 3. No. Rebound. Hit the floor. Martin got it. and gives it over to Younger.
See, I want you to look at what Gaddy does. He's just working, setting himself up on the block. I think that's what Montgomery should be doing. Montgomery should just be working and trying to set himself up on the block and let his offensive game come to him that way instead of trying to work on the perimeter so much. You saw the last couple of times he had on the perimeter, he forced a bad jumper, he had a turnover. I think if Montgomery just works on the block, EJ can just totally destroy this game.
Right, no doubt about that. And also, if you look down, let's look at McEachern, though. One thing McEachern done is pace himself and take a solid shot.
Exactly. Exactly.
Sharife Cooper finally finds the range. He knocks in a three ball, 46-40.
Cooper makes that shot because they were patient on offense. No rush, just patience.
That's one thing we talk about with this McEachern team. Yes, they're young, but they're so, I don't want to say cocky because that's not what it is. They're so confident and patient. They don't get rattled. They don't get too high. They don't get too low.
Nope, and like I said, in a game like this, we always talk about a game of runs.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? You get a run, you know, a team's going to take a run, and the thing is you got to be able to absorb that run and then go on your own run. And if a team that can take somebody's run and then go on their own run, they're going to be successful.
Ooh, that's a push-off.
Quentin McElroy has checked into the ball game and an offensive foul called on the Wheeler Wildcats.
You can tell the strength of Austin Johnson. Austin Johnson literally had one hand, and he shoved his man a good 10 feet off of him to get that open space for that layup.
46-40, 2:14 to go. Breed to Okora. Okora goes down the line, reverse layup on the other side. Good. Isaac Okora having his way. 48-40. McEachern has pushed the lead out to 8 now. Younger between the legs as we go under 2 minutes. Younger going to drive on Gordon, put it up, float. Good, nice move, Brandon Younger, 6'7 and a senior.
Nice floater by Younger.
His first field goal, 48-42. Breed, Allen Breed over to McElroy. On a short, dark pass to Okora. Inside out, Breed, shoulder range, no good. Rebound, oh, went through the five hole of Gaddy, picked up by Younger. Younger bounce pass over in the corner to Holt, catch fire, a three. A wedgie, we have a wedgie. Jump ball. McEachern ball.
All these high flyers down there, nobody went up there to get it. There we go.
I don't want to spend that energy, man. Stat Row showcases few sport highlights and gives a portion of its residue back to the teams. Visit StatRow.com to learn how your team can partner with Stat Row. 80 seconds. Here's Okora to Breed. Breed wanted to shoot the three, now going to drive and dump it off to a cutting Okora. Got it knocked away. He recovered it. Back out top. Here's McElroy. He traveled. Coach Thompson now going to have a word with the ref, Coach Mike Thompson of the McEachern Indians. Very upset, Coach Thompson. A timeout now has been called by Wheeler's head coach Larry Thompson. 48-42. Barry, what do you see?
The pace of the game has changed a little bit. Like I said, McEachern's starting to slow down a little bit. Willis seems to be on a rush for some odd reason. And like I said, they're rushing shots. Guys are just taking jump shots. And then once they're getting the ball in the post, some guys aren't being able to score. They need to run some offense, like Sly said, and kind of get going.
Mm-hmm. Sit down, set up your offense, run your offense, and let – your offense is designed for you to score. It's the reason you practice it. It's the reason you run it. So why not go and do it? Run that offense. Set that offense up. Run a few seconds off the clock. It's 1 minute to go in the third quarter. You still got a whole quarter to play. Run your offense. Set it up. Get you an easy basket out of your offensive set.
7 3 balls by Wheeler. 5 from McEachern, just to give you a little influx on that. No double-figure scorers outside of Okora for McEachern. He leads them with 15. And then Jair Eastman still on the bench. He has 10. He is the only double-figure scorer right now. So that's kind of surprising just a little bit.
Yeah.
No doubt about it, considering that you got, like I said, you got Tennessee State commit, Austin Johnson, Isaac Martin, and E.J. Montgomery.
Johnson has been somewhat quiet. He has 7 points in the contest and an offensive foul. Wheeler now being hit with the offensive fouls. 59 and 4:10 seconds.
And that's the second one on Austin Johnson. Him, trying to battle down there for position, and I didn't realize how strong Austin is. Either Austin Johnson is really strong, or the McEachern Indians aren't that strong, are really weak, because he's pushing them around like rag dolls.
He has toughened up a little bit just from last year, just in the quick, you know, three quarters. We've seen him on the cut. McElroy, left hand layup, good.
Beautiful, beautiful. McEachern excels at cutting without the basketball. These wings on McEachern, they all cut so well without the basketball. They attack that hole without the ball.
30 seconds. Spins it in the corner. Knocked away. Good job, Allen Breed.
But it starts with Isaac Okor coming up to the high post and then flashing out and then making guys follow him. And then all of a sudden, they're opening up the area for them to go down the lane and make a play.
25 seconds. Here's Holt. Inside to Johnson, turn, put it on the floor, and they're going to spin. Went up, bothered again by Akinbola, who was there. I love the discipline of Babatunde Akinbola. Kick it. Tip to McElroy. McElroy back out to Okora. He takes a look at the clock with 7 seconds. Okora now going to make his move. Spins it to the left. Gordon, a long three. No, at the end of the third quarter. We move to the fourth and final frame. 50-42, McEachern holding an 8-point lead.
Defensive-wise, though.
That space so well.
Here's a great point I want to back you up on, Barry, about the pace. Wheeler, 25 points in the first quarter. Since then, they have not scored in double figures in back-to-back quarters, 8 points and 9 points as we go into the fourth. Here we are, Loving Good Arena, the fourth and final frame. Man, the game has flown by. Johnson holds it out between on the high wing. Gives it now to EJ. EJ off the window, good.
And you see what he did? He was inside the paint. He was inside the lane. That's where EJ needs to stay. And he can blow this game out the water if he stays his behind in the paint.
McEachern, I'm sorry, go ahead.
And no rush. They just got a bucket, took their time.
And you want a bucket like that since you're basically coming out of a timeout to start the quarter. McEachern in the white, Wheeler in the navy blue. The pass is high. Here's Eastman. Eastman back in. Now Martin. Martin dunked it home with the left hand. Jair Eastman is back in the game. He got just a little bit of a giddy up in him, but he's in there. Three ball. McElroy stripped the nets. Quentin McElroy.
That's how you answer.
The sharing and caring from McEachern. EJ drives on a foul called on Akinbola.
He got the foul. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Eight players have scored for the McEachern Indians. Nobody in double figures outside of Isaac Okor, who has a team high 15.
Looks like EJ is starting to be a little bit more aggressive as well, too.
But the thing is, I need him to be aggressive inside the lane. I don't need him to be aggressive on the wing because I truly don't think Akinbola can control him down there if he's down that low. I don't think too many people in the state of Georgia can control E.J. Montgomery if he's inside that lane. If he's on the wing, I can stick Sharife Coop out there and stop him on the wing.
The 6'10 senior split the free throws. 6-point ball game as we have a minute gone by. In the corner, a three ball. Gordon, get it out the bottom of the net. Devin Gordon, his third three. He's now in double figures. He has 10 in the contest. Younger to Montgomery. Montgomery worked on by Akinbola. Across the lane, swooping with the left hand. Go.
Nice move. Nice finish.
I guess maybe I need to shut up.
56-49. McEachern with Breed on a screen roll action. Akinbola shot, putting it in. It's good. Beautiful. Akinbola in double figures now with 10.
Beautiful pick and roll action.
Montgomery going to go spinning on him.
count it,
count the
and the foul. The hoop and the horn. Akinbola and Montgomery now going back and forth.
I'm just going to shut up.
And I like it, Barry. You see it. Folks, you couldn't see. Barry looked at me, and he said, I think EJ being a little more aggressive and gave a little nod. Here it is, man.
No doubt about it, man. This is what I wanted to see from EJ right here. The former Auburn commit really going to the basket. Like you said, Fly, posting up, going to the basket, a jump hook, a nice spin move here and there, and now here we go.
Completes the three-point play. It's still 6 points. Look at the pass. McElroy layup blew it. He was bothered. Good job by Eastman.
Eastman
he's still hobbling, though. He's trying to gut it out, but he's hobbling. EJ, elbow jumper. He's warming to the pass.
He's feeling it. He's feeling it.
EJ Montgomery has begun warming to the task. Devin Gordon has it. He gives it to Breed. Breed, Gordon, McElroy, Akinbola, and Okora, the five on the floor for the McEachern Indians with a four-point lead. Now the crowd starts to get loud. Breed flips it up. Count it. No. A travel.
Too many steps. Too many steps. It looked good. I tell you what, if he makes it to the NBA, he'll get that one.
Hope will come out. Eastman will go out. Hope comes in. And Coach Thompson sees that he's limping, and he's trying not to limp. But he's got a little giddy up in it. Holt is in, Younger with Montgomery, Johnson, and Martin across the lane. Used a body dump and a foul that called it on the floor.
And no doubt about it, Akinbola's having trouble guarding EJ Montgomery.
He can't guard him on the wing.
On the move, going left. Now he needs to make him use that offhand, that right hand. And let's see. That's the thing. He's catching that ball over here on his right wing. He's working right to left.
Yep.
You see what I'm saying?
He's sweeping to the left to the inside of the lane.
Now you have to force him to go baseline. Let's see. Now let's see the adjustments. This is when the coaches get their money.
58-54, 5:36. EJ Montgomery has warmed up. Free throw, short, front end, no good on a 1-1. Akinbola the rebound, gives it to Okora. 5.5 to go. Glad that you're with us, Joel Hillsman, Sylvester Williams, and Barry Browner. Loving Good Arena on the campus of McEachern High School, Powder Springs, Georgia. This is a season opener. Gordon, pump fake, lay him near his feet, shot up and a foul. I like how Gordon, even the threat of the pump fake, had the defender leaving his feet.
Coming into this game, we didn't know much about Devin Gordon, but Devin Gordon is really produced tonight.
I like how Devin Gordon played last year. He came in. And I'm going to use an NBA reference here. He knew his role last year.
Yes.
Off the bench, came in, stretched the defense with a little bit, kept some threes, and that's one of the things that I think has allowed him to expand his role in minutes now.
Now you bring the horses back in the game. Cooper Jones came back into the game. Who else? Somebody else over there. I can't see his number. Getting ready. Suggs is about to come back into
Suggs
the game.
About to come in. About to go with the starters. He's probably going to get Gordon. They've got a blow for a 5-18. And free throw. Gordon, good.
That's a great job by your second unit of maintaining the lead while your first unit is out the game. That's what you want out of your second unit guys. Just maintain. If you can stretch out the lead, great. But make sure those second unit guys can maintain the lead. That's what you want out of them.
6 points may be that magic number. Wheeler can't get closer than that. Well, they got close at four. Here's Younger. Younger over to Hope. Hope, now look at Akinbola way out high. There's a matchup problem if they go with Montgomery because Cooper's on him. Jared Jones going to try to front him out here. Under 5 minutes. Martin, a three from the left wing. Hill of the rim, no good. Suggs tipped the rebound. Okora comes away with it. Pushes it up to Cooper. Sharife Cooper spins it across to Suggs. Suggs going to drive all the way, put it up off the window. No, and a foul underneath. Foul call, and Brandon Suggs will go to the free throw line. E.J. Montgomery runs all the way down to the other end of the floor in disagreement. And Coach Thompson wants an explanation. The Wheeler crowd letting Mr. Ref know about it. Suggs to the free throw line. He has 3 points in the contest. Okora was 17 in the contest. Devin Gordon with 12. And Babatunde Akinbola with 10. Coach Thompson does not like the explanation that he's getting. Did E.J. Montgomery just foul out? Wow, that's why he's upset. Five fouls with 4:43. Coach, that's why Coach Thompson is upset, because he knew he was stretching his dime with four fouls.
Exactly. And you can tell EJ is bad, because EJ was just starting to get into his groove.
Yeah, he was. That's a big, big call there.
But now if you're the Wildcat faithful, you're really looking at Austin Johnson right now to see what he can do on the inside and work in the paint,
Coach,
and work his magic.
Coach Larry Thompson of Wheeler, he is still giving this ref the business. I mean, he is lighting into him. And then when Suggs missed the free throw, of course he said, now you know it wasn't a foul. He split him. 4 points. EJ fouls out with 13. 4.5. Got to go the rest of the way without the horse that was warming. Eastman is back in. I agree with you, Sly. I do want to see a little bit more from Austin Johnson. Johnson now will hand it off to Younger. Isaac Martin, though, has played with more confidence and playing well. Holt drives, get it out. A block now. Foul called on Suggs. Whistles are beginning to blow. A cameraman going to use the other word. I hate that word on Al, but I get you. 61-54, 7-point lead for the McEachern Indians. And Isaac Holt at the line, 6'2 and a senior. Holt on the day with 7 points.
Ooh.
Fell out. Ball don't lie.
Isaac wasn't living right.
Was not.
Will is starting to miss a lot of free throws. And I use the word free.
I do too. If free 99, you got to take them. You got to cash them in. 61-54. Those were two big blown free throws there. And EJ missed the front end of the 1-1 of us a minute ago. Jones with a bad pass out of bounds. It will stay with McEachern. And Coach Mike Thompson lighting up into Jarrett Jones. Jones has not yet had the effect on the game you would think. He catches that one across the lane. Akinbola, jumper, short, Suggs, up, count it, and the foul. Brandon Suggs, and one.
That's a great job of just positioning, just putting yourself in the right spot, making sure you're there to box out, even though he wasn't, no way he could have told that was going to be an air ball, but he had great position with his box out and his body in the way so he could get that rebound and put it right back up for an easy two.
Suggs, free throw. Good. He completes the three-point play. He has 7 points in the game. Look at that. 10-point McEachern lead, 64-54. Under 4 minutes. We've halfway home in the fourth. Here's Martin. Martin feeds it to Johnson. Johnson turns on the face. Johnson stops. Dipped the shoulder. Knocked away. A steal. Akinbola, great defense. Here comes Coop. Up ahead to Okora. Okora going across the lane. Up. No, and a foul.
Great team defense. Great team defense by the McEachern Indians. Akinbola weighed himself. He planted himself in the lane to absorb the contact from Johnson. And I'm not sure who reached his hand in there to strip that ball out. I think it might have been Jones.
Jones deflected it. Akinbola went ahead and finished it.
Exactly. Great team defense by the McEachern Indians.
And notice, fellas, what McEachern's doing now. Now they're trying to attack the basket a little bit more with EJ Montgomery out.
Yes. Attack the basket, pick up a foul, or get an easy layup.
17 foul. McEachern actually has more fouls at 9. Alcora, free throw, no good. Now both teams beginning to lead points at the free throw line.
One thing you don't want to do in any ball game is lead points. It's these easy baskets, these free throws.
15 points right now.
Lane violation.
Leaving all the points there. Jarrett Jones with the lane violation. The referees are getting their money's worth today. Coach Thompson, both of them, are giving them the business. Coach Thompson wants an explanation. Palms up to the sky. So now here's Younger. Younger going to pull a deep three. Front iron, no. Rebound hit the floor. Offensive rebound out of the guard spot. Eastman shot up, no, and he was fouled by Cooper.
Eastman. Somebody needs to give Eastman an award for that one. He acted like he got shot on that.
Devin Gordon will come in. Sharife Cooper went and sat right to the bench. He went and sat down. Foul was on Sharife Cooper.
Good hustle by Eastman to get that loose ball, though.
Free throw rolled off. No good.
Let's take a guess what the McEachern Indians will be doing at practice on Monday.
McEachern and Wheeler.
And Wheeler.
I'm sorry, Wheeler. That's what I meant. What will Wheeler be doing at practice on Monday?
Free throw good. He split them. 11 in the game for Jair Eastman, who got Wheeler off to that huge start. Kicked off to Jones. Jones waited on him. All right, he walked out of the gym. Austin Johnson seeing some mistakes here in the latter moments of the fourth quarter. You gotta clean that up, both teams. Here's Eastman. Eastman gonna attack on Gordon. Layup. It rolled off. Tip. Fight for it. Gordon gets the defensive rebound. Gordon now outlets it, and here comes Okora. Okora across the timeline. Okora with the left hand. Jump stopping through the lane. Scoring on a roll. No, it fell off. Gordon couldn't get it. Suggs fights for it down low. Johnson, now they battle for it. Jump ball will be called.
One thing I'm noticing on the Wheeler end of the court is on offense is if they don't score, they don't get another shot.
No.
As opposed to McEachern, they're getting one, two, maybe three opportunities. Wheeler's not doing a good job of boxing out and getting those rebounds.
Second chance points.
Second chance
Second
point.
Chance opportunities. Or, as you want to say, one shot and out is what you're saying. Great point there, Barry, because McEachern is getting the second chance opportunities, and both teams getting scrappy. McEachern gets the jump ball arrow. They have a 9-point lead. It looks healthy at the moment. 2:50 to go. Breed gonna drive, got hit, back to the top. Gordon, jab step, floats through the lane, good. Devin Gordon, solid.
They didn't change the possession out either. Still have
14. Yeah, it does. It needs to go to Wheeler now. Yep, there's a shot up, no. Rebound's gonna come down to Suggs. Suggs has it, outlet it, pass up to Allen Breed. Breed, layup, good, Allen Breed. He has 7 in the game, and Coach Larry Thompson has had enough. He calls a timeout, 68-55 with 2:21 to go. McEachern has blown it open to a 13-point lead. CBA Sports is a sports construction firm specializing in performance athletic surfacing, sports floor systems, and sports components for both indoor and outdoor sports flooring projects. Visit cbasports.com for more information. Wow. And I started sending them to the exits.
I'm telling you right now, they're trying to beat the traffic going home.
68-55, the McEachern Indians. I mentioned it to you, Barry. 8 points in the second for Wheeler, 9 in the third. Now, here in the fourth, they're currently at 13 points. The second and third quarters, not good for Wheeler. And then even when they were able to pull it down to 4, it was 58-54. It's been a 10-1 run since then.
Right, no doubt. Wheeler just had a tough time getting buckets, just stringing buckets together. So it, as opposed to McEachern, they're doing a better job. They're just doing a better job getting the buckets that they need and making timely plays.
E.J. Montgomery fouled out at the 4:46 mark. So I think that little push after that, I think because you made a great point, he was beginning to get it going. He right. was warming to the task. He finished with 13.
And that's pretty solid. He finished with 13 because I think the first half he might have had 2.
Exactly. He did. He had 2 at the half. So he had 11 points in that little span, but they were coming right there. He was a help part of that push, a long 3. No good. 2:02. 2 minutes. 13-point lead. Suggs now will hold it. McEachern will start working on that clock. Driving. Suggs layup good there at the 70-point mark. Eight players have scored for the McEachern Indians, and they've got contributions from everywhere. But Okora, who last year Okora put up 24.1 points a game and made second team All-State, Akinbola, the rim protector, we saw that, but not the heavy lifting night from Okora. Though, kind of like with E.J. Montgomery earlier in the second quarter when they needed the hoops, he got them in bunches.
Right, exactly. What are you guys taking from this game from both teams, though?
McEachern is talented. McEachern has
has talent, and they have shooters. They're deep. And what I've noticed all day, a lot of teams are deep with shooters, but McEachern have guys who can put it up. I mean, who shot a couple of them? Breed, Gordon.
McElroy.
Who else? They had a couple of guys.
Coop hit a three, too.
Coop hit a three. You know, and another thing that surprised me about McEachern is Akinbola. Akinbola started off the game hitting two outside jumpers. So now you have a real inside out, a high-low game that you can play with Akinbola and Jones. You put Jones down low, and Akinbola can hit that shot, that jumper on the outside.
Okoro, he tried to take his head off. He tried to come take your head off, Austin Johnson. Johnson doesn't like that he got the foul. And look at Okoro. Okoro walking back. Oh, ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh, wee. Now, you know how many people would have missed that left.
All these people left the gym.
They would have missed that. They would have had to go to Stat Row because Stat Row showcases youth sports highlights and gives a portion of his revenue back to the team. Visit StatRow.com today to learn how your team can partner with Stat Row. That would have been a 10-second clip. And that would have been a pinned tweet on SUV.
Oh, yes, sir.
So, Sly, what do you take from Wheeler, though?
I like Wheeler's game. I'm pleasantly surprised at Eastman. I love how this young man has stepped up and he's accepted the responsibility of being the lead guard for Wheeler. I love how he stepped up. EJ Montgomery, everybody in the entire Southeast knows EJ Montgomery is probably the best big man in the state of Georgia. So that nothing he did surprised me. It's just that foul trouble and just not working on the inside of the lane. I loved how he decided to take over the game in the fourth quarter. I love that. But see, now you can use that. Now, and Austin Johnson, one more time, Austin Johnson is a force down there in the paint. He's a strong kid playing down there, playing down low, kind of having his way. Who else? Martin. Martin's a shooter on the outside.
Right.
Martin's a shooter.
I think the Will is talented. Like you, I'm surprised. I'm not gonna speak for you guys, but I think coming in, my question mark was at the point guard position.
Mm-hmm.
I thought the Eastman proved. He had a good night. I actually think that he outplayed Cooper.
I was just about to go ahead and say he outplayed Coop today.
I think I've got to see more. EJ's got to do a little bit more. I think I've got to get a little bit more from Austin Johnson and Isaac Martin. I think Willer is Willer's Brandon Younger. I think Willer's going to be in the thick of it. I just think that there's some things that they've got to work on, though. But after seeing Norcross, seeing the top three teams today, I don't know where I'm at with my who's 1, 2, and 3 right now.
It's easy for me, McEachern. But and the way this game started, the adversity that they kind of had to overcome because of the energy that was in the building, Wheeler, all of a sudden, they didn't hush the crowd because, of course, they had crowd here too. And they pushed that lead up very quickly and had a 9-10-point lead on McEachern at home in the early moments. We mentioned they never get too high. They never get too low. You saw that. They were able to withstand that, come back, and made a run to their depth. I'm not surprised. I do like what I saw from Wheeler. And, yes, they're going to be in the thick of it. And, yes, they're going to be a force to reckon with. I like what they've got going on. McEachern, just one level above them.
Right. When I looked at the three teams I looked at today, more important were the four teams in 7A, Metal Creek, Norcross, Wheeler, and McEachern. I'll be honest with you. I like Metal Creek. I like Metal Creek, and I like Norcross. I'm just not sure yet. I think McEachern probably is. They'll continue to be number one until somebody knocks them off. But this is a big win for them and Coach Thompson, and that's a good way to start the season off.
You know what I like about McEachern? McEachern dominated this game pretty much. And Cooper had a bad game.
That's what I'm saying.
What happens when Cooper has a good game? McEachern's going to be something to be scared of.
As the final score, 71-59, McEachern and Wheeler, it's very good. And I'm going to elaborate on your point just another minute. I like the fact we saw a very good Meadow Creek team. I was thoroughly impressed with them. I think we saw Tiff's got a little work to do to come back. Norcross is really deep.
Right.
Norcross is deep. I don't think they're deeper than McEachern.
No.
I don't think they're deeper than McEachern. I mean, McEachern had 8 guys score. Jared Jones only had 2 points. Nobody scored over 20. They hit 7 threes. That's a lot of balance.
Right. That's a lot of balance. And probably the most balanced team we saw today.
No doubt
about that. I know Sly and I talked about, even though Norcross didn't play Muhammad today, there's just one Muhammad.
Yeah, it's just one Muhammad.
It's just one Muhammad. It's going to be tough against Akibola, Okor, and Jared Jones, most definitely. And the same thing with Wheeler. So it'll be interesting to see, man. I think the 7A this year is going to be very, very, very good. I think you got about five or six teams, man, that can win it all.
But you know what I want from these three teams or these four? Well, three teams especially, because Metal Creek won't play any national games. But what I need from the Georgia teams on the national scene, I think last year, nationally, the Georgia teams let us down. I think they let us down nationally. When they went to these national tournaments, Green Forest didn't quite play like we expected them to play because Justin Forrest was out for most of the year. Westlake didn't show up nationally. Nationally, Wheeler didn't show up nationally when they played those national tournaments. So that's in Norcross.
That's where I think what the majority of McEachern's players did this year nationally.
Yes.
I think that puts them in a position. I'm not going to be jaded in it. McEachern is the best basketball team in Georgia.
Yes.
They are a top five team nationally, period. And they are playing a national schedule to be able to go and do and showcase that. I really think you're going to need a lot to beat McEachern. I just really do. And you might need some strikes to beat McEachern.
Right. And you guys touched on a good point. Cooper was off tonight.
Very much.
I mean, and so that's scary. Did they beat a good Wheeler team by what, 12?
12 points, 71-59, and ended the game on a 13-4 run.
Well, that's scary.
That's scary.
That's scary.
Barry, a pleasure, man.
Always, always, man. I look forward to doing this again.
Pleasure working with you,
Barry. He's Barry Browner. He's Sylvester Williams. I'm Joe Hillsman. Final quick numbers. Okora 15, Gordon 15, Akinbola 10. 15 was the high for McEachern. For Wheeler, Eastman 13, and Montgomery 13. And just to touch on it again, I will say, and I like Coop. I like Coop 6 points. Didn't shoot the ball well, has struggled. Eastman, the three threes in the beginning and the way he played defensively, played through a little ankle injury. Coop being off, Eastman doing what he did, I did think he outplayed him today. And I think you hit it on the head early about the point guard matchup.
Mm-hmm. Right, no doubt.
All right. Well, we thank all of you guys for joining us all six games here at the Georgia's Elite Eight Tip-Off Classic here at Loving Good Arena on the campus of McEachern High School. A wonderful day. Thank you again. I'm Joel Hillsman and our entire crew, for Barry, for Sly, my wonderful producer, Lisa. A great camera work. I'm Joel Hillsman. We'll see you down the road right here, the SUVTV.com.